looking at today, they are in this present college scenario, or you can say, there is one thing, which is the academics, which I focus on, or there is this equivalent pool of activities which will help me develop my personality, in the sense that I develop or get better in an activity, in a specific activity which might help me in future in my life. So in general, I might have the belief that yes, I should do good in academics. So for that, I need to excel. Like you can't excel in 2 out of 10 and then say that yeah, I did good, because if I want to excel, then I have to do good in so and so academics. So, but maybe that academic might not help me in my life in the future. And let's say I get a good CG, but that doesn't mean that tomorrow I would be happier. So, what should be the balance which I must have, and how should I prioritize things so that I get contented? And what is contentment all about? Let's say 5 years, 10 years down the line, what will be what is contentment all about? When there is there are lots of things happening around me, and I want to decide what I want to do in life. Because let's say I see seniors all around me. I see people who might be involved, who are gonna get a very good job, and who are going to earn splendidly. But that seems very much brightening to me. But on the other hand, I see that there are many false means which they take up for that, which I personally won't accept it, and which would be against my principles. But okay, there is this benefit, and then they are taking this cost. And along with that, I also see that these people are doing all the things which they do today for the heck of getting what that main aim is. So is it right to compromise on what I would call contentment, because they are only seeing the future and deciding that yes, if I do this today, it will help me go there. Not that whether this is making me happy or not, this small thing today, whether this is making me happy or not, they don't think about that. But they make sure that okay, this will help me build a block which will take me to that place where I want to go eventually. So is this the right thing?
Thanks for raising this. There are two questions in this. One, what is contentment? Second, can it be obtained by doing something in the future? Is contentment a thing of the future? The answer is contained in our own daily activities and what we see around us. What satisfies a terrorist? Killing. What satisfies a scientist? More time spent in the lab. What is a Hindu interested in? Temples. What's a Muslim interested in? Mosques. What would be an Indian nationalist interested in? India. What would be a man interested in? Women. Don't you see that what satisfies you, what satisfies you, comes deeply from how you are conditioned? Are you getting it? You find satisfaction only in that which you are conditioned to be satisfied in. So this satisfaction then happens to be quite an ugly word, because this satisfaction is nothing but a continuation of the repetitive patterns of the past. this satisfaction is not even yours. You have been trained to be satisfied in this. You have been trained to be satisfied in this and that. And that is the reason why this satisfaction is never really complete. Isn't it obvious? You do something and that never really satisfies you, and hence you hop onto something else. You reach there, but that point is never final. So you want to hop onto something else. Had that really satisfied you, would you still have tried to do something more and more and more? He wants to ask, what kind of balance should I take up? What would be a satisfactory balance? The answer cannot be given directly. But yes, what can be certainly said is that let it not be an external influence that decides this. Let it not come from your seniors or from anybody else. If it comes from there, it cannot be your own. It cannot be a product of your intelligence. Let it not come from the general trend. There is no fun really in being a part of the crowd. And also, there is no fun in remaining separate for the heck of it. I am not advocating that. That everybody is going towards one side on the road, so you start driving the wrong side. You know, I don't do what the crowd does, so I drive wrong side. Against the crowd. Not that, not really that. Because even in that, you are dependent upon the crowd. That if the crowd goes right, I go left. You are still dependent. You are still a follower of the crowd. The word satisfaction is quite intriguing. It is always something to be obtained, right? Always. And it lies in the future. And the word future must ring a bell. The moment we say future, we mean the time, yes, and hence are you getting it? A hunt for satisfaction necessarily means that right now you are correct. Unhappy, dissatisfied. Now look at this absurd logic of the brain. It says right now I am dissatisfied, right now there is a disease and I'll cure it in the future. If you are sick right now, you need a medicine right now. You cannot say that I am so miserable and my life is pathetic, but the day I'll pass out and get a nice job, then I'll be satisfied and happy. And what about the remaining 4 years? You live life today and you think you will be satisfied then. So don't you see what you're doing out of your life? You're wasting it, absolutely wasting it. Everybody who lives in dreams and ambitions is making a terrible waste of his life. Everybody and anybody who is running after results of any kind is surely wasting his life. Because chasing results means you are not in love with the moment. And in the moment there is always a process. That you are not in love with the process. It would be on one particular day that the results will be declared, right? But life is continuous, every moment. If happiness belongs to that one moment when the results are declared, then it's a very poor life. Are you getting it? You get your salary check on one particular day in the month. But how many days do you work? If happiness belongs to that one particular day when you get that check, then what about the other 29 days? How do you spend them? In misery? That's what we do. We spend those days in misery. I will be happy when that result comes. I will be happy when I beat him. I will be happy when my CGPA exceeds 8.5. I will be happy when, and that when is always in future. And future is always in the brain. There is no future. Life is this moment. And those who live in their aims and objectives necessarily miss out on life. Are you getting it? Look at the poverty of those who say that, you know, this is a stepping stone and there is a ladder, that proverbial ladder of success, and we are climbing up that ladder. And when you put your leg on one rung, then you put your leg on another rung. What they don't say is, you are not satisfied at any rung of the ladder. You are miserable at every step. That is the reason why you keep climbing up. Up and up and up. And there is no real movement taking place because at every step, you are still miserable. Is the patient improving if day after day his condition is still miserable? And the doctor keeps telling, you know, tomorrow he will be satisfied with his condition. Tomorrow he will be satisfied with his condition. And in our life, there is always a tomorrow, right? A great tomorrow. That tomorrow something will happen and then I will be satisfied. You go to a doctor and he keeps telling you, tomorrow, 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 tomorrow. And there is this infinite series of tomorrows. What kind of doctor is that? Surely a quack. Our brain is that kind of a doctor. It keeps you in illusions all the time that there is something great in the future. There is something great in the future. And we have understood, right? Why the brain is always looking at the future? Because of its own insecurity, because of its inability to live in the present. Yes. Speak.
So then, how do you condition your brain to live in the present?
You can't condition your brain to live in the present. You can only be aware of the processes of the brain. You see, the brain is like a machine, right? However much you alter it, you will change its design. You may do a few other changes. You can entirely change its programming. But however much you change its programming, it would still remain a machine, bound by its programming. Old programming or new programming? Programming is programming. Programming is slavery. Are you getting it? The brain can never go beyond its programming. Yes, there can be different kinds of programming, Hindu programming and Muslim programming. Young programming and old programming, male programming and female programming. There can be different kinds of programming, but the brain can never go beyond the programming. So don't talk of doing too much with the brain. Talk of that intelligence that can understand this programming. The brain is programmed and it cannot understand that it is programmed. Intelligence understands that the brain is programmed. What does intelligence do? Intelligence looks at the brain. This is called witnessing. Intelligence looks at the brain and understands that it is a machine and hence not to be taken very seriously. Are you getting it? That is the only way you become a master of the brain rather than the brain becoming a master of you. How do you look at the brain? By looking at what it does every day from morning till the evening. By remaining alert, awake and conscious. So you see how habituated it is. And what is a habit? A repetition of the past, right? You see how habituated it is. You wake up in the morning and you immediately reach out to that what your habit tells you. You go to the same set of people every day. You are habituated to calling as friends. To be intelligent is to look into all this and more. The habits that the brain follows, its sense of insecurity, boredom, frustration that we come across every day. It is to be alert right now. What is it doing? What is it doing? Even right now, is it listening or is it wandering in thoughts? And we all know that thoughts are time. That is the only way you go beyond the brain. And to go beyond the brain is to go beyond slavery and become a master. Not by trying to alter the shape of the brain, not by enforcing some discipline upon you, but by intelligently understanding the limitations of the brain. And the limitations of the brain can be seen only in its functioning, how it functions, how you get angry very soon, how lust and other impulses arise in you of a purely mechanical nature, chemical driven, hormone driven. By observing all this, not by suppressing all this, not by fighting it. You do not fight a machine. What fun is there in fighting a machine? You understand the machine, right? As intelligent people, what do? Do you fight machines? No. You understand their design. You understand their input and output methods. And when you have understood a machine, you have mastered the machine, right? So you understand the brain. You are sitting and a thought comes to you. And you don't become a slave of that thought. You say, oh, all right, now I understand where this thought is coming from. Okay, let it be there. You have become very emotional upon hearing something or reading something. You do not let the emotion overpower you. You say, I know what this thing called emotion is. It is nothing but the manifestation of thought. When the thought becomes very intense, it takes the shape of emotion. And then life is different, very, very different. That is the way the intelligent being deals with the brain. Observes it, witnesses it, looks at it. Yes.
So